Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing three mistakes to avoid in your child custody case. If you are new to the channel, my name is Nashia. I'm a mom. I'm also a family law attorney, and I love to motivate, inspire, and encourage others. So here on my channel, I share a lot of videos regarding mindset motivation, but I also share content as it relates to custody, divorce, and other issues as it relates to family law, because those are my two passions. I love family law and I also love to encourage others. So you'll see a blend of those two different types of content here on my channel. Now, like I said, in this video, I'm going to be sharing three mistakes to avoid in your child custody case. And so let me tell you, these are things that I see. These are just three. This is not an exhaustive list. There are other mistakes that people make, but I just wanted to share three just to keep the message concise, because I know that, you know, attention spans can be pretty short. And so I wanted to make the video not super, super too long. So that being said, let's go ahead and get straight into the video. All right. So number one, and I have my notes written down, because if you're new to the channel, you may not know that I love to go off on tangents. And so my notes help me to stay on track. Okay. So if you see me looking down, that means I'm looking at my notes. All right. So number one, not preserving evidence. So this is a mistake that people often make. What I mean by not preserving evidence, I mean by not keeping track of your text messages, right? Specifically for custody cases, a lot of the evidence is going to be text messages, maybe some photos. But for majority of my cases, they're pretty much text messages. Like I said, maybe some photos. And if it's child support involved, we're looking at pay stubs and stuff like that. But not preserving evidence. I mean, there's countless of times where I work with people and they may say, oh, well, I no longer have those messages, or those messages were on my old phone. I don't have them anymore. And so that's something that you want to be mindful of. Also, there are things that you see on social media, and I'm kind of going into number two. But say, for example, if you saw something on social media, but then you did not save it at that time, and then you go back and now it's deleted, right? Because that person realized, okay, we're in the middle of a custody litigation. I need to go back and clean up my social media. And so with that being said, that actually leads me to number two. Number two, your social media. That's another mistake that people make when it involves child custody cases, involves putting things on your social media that you do not want a judge to see. And so I've actually been able to use posts on social media that people have posted to use that against them in court. So for example, I had one particular case where, let's just say, the other parent had some content on his channel that showed him engaging in violent activity, right? Drug and violent related activity. So I'm talking about guns and drugs and, you know, him basically flashing these things, right? Suggesting that this is his lifestyle. And so I was able to use that to introduce that evidence and to get the judge to take a look at that. And the judge actually considered that evidence when she made her decision about what would be in the best interest for the child. So you're going to be very, very mindful. I understand a lot of times in these custody cases, they can become very, very, you know, emotionally overwhelming, exhausting, and frustrated. You may be a little angry, but you may want to just channel that into a different medium, right? You may want to just write in your diary, talk to a therapist. I would strongly encourage you not to post any of that on your social media, and just be very, very mindful of what you do post, and know that if 9 times out of 10, there's another attorney involved in the case, they're going to look at your social media and they're going to be monitoring your social media and they're going to see what you're posting up there. So you want to be very, very mindful of that. Okay. And number three, like I said, this is not an exhaustive list. These are just three mistakes that you want to avoid. Number three, this is a common one. You want to avoid refraining contact with the other parent. Okay. Absent some safety concern. So before I go any further with this, let me first say that I'm not giving any particular legal advice. This is just legal information based on the things that I've observed in my practice, right? So I would encourage you to contact an attorney in your jurisdiction, all right? I'm not your attorney. Listen, don't say, oh, Nashia Conway told me. No, okay? I'm just telling you something that I see and something that could be used against you if you go to court, all right? So if you're just refraining contact and there's no legitimate reason or justification, that's not going to work out too well with you when you go to court, all right? Like I said, now there are exceptions to that. There may be a safety concern. There may be a situation where, let's say, the other parent was never involved with the child at all and you just don't feel comfortable. Maybe the child doesn't feel, you know, comfortable being around this person because they don't really know who this person is. I mean, there are other, you know, variations. There are other variables that could be at play that would, you know, basically go against what I'm telling you. But basically what I'm trying to say, if there are no concerns, no safety concerns, and it's just a matter of, you know, you're just upset or you're just angry that this person had the audacity to take you to court, and you say, you know what, I'm not gonna let you see the child until we go to court. Don't do that. Do not do that. The judges don't like that, and they will really, you know, look at you in a bad light when you do that. So you don't want to do that, okay? All right, so let me check my time. Wow, I'm actually over 5 minutes. I said this video is going to be 5 minutes long. So with that being said, those are just three things, right? Three mistakes to avoid when you have a child custody case, all right? And so if you want me to make another video, maybe I can do a series about mistakes to avoid in your child custody case. Let me know down below in the comment section, or just let me also, you can also let me know by hitting the like button if you think this would be helpful. If you are a person who are in a process of, maybe you have to represent yourself in court because you can't afford an attorney, and you're like, look, I just need to get some information that can help me somewhat, then let me know and I'll be happy to make more content like this that could help you as you prepare for your case. I'm also going to be making some videos as it relates to mistakes to avoid in your divorce case as well. So again, if you think that content would be helpful, please let me know in the comment section. Also hit the like button. And if there are any other things that would be helpful for you, let's say you're a person who are in the process of representing yourself, if there's anything else that would be helpful for you, just give me some ideas and let me know, and I can make some videos on that. I do know that actually my daughter told me that, you know, I love her so much. She said, well, mommy, maybe you can make a video about just some tips that they can have as far as like how to represent yourself in court, you know, by yourself, which I think is an awesome idea. So I'll be sure to make a video on that as well. But again, if you have any other suggestions that would be helpful, then let me know down below. And until next time, be blessed, stay blessed. Same thing. I just like to say it twice, and I'll see you guys soon in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.